You are welcome to my YouTube channel, Oma's Vlog. I'm happy to have you around today. How is your day going? Alright. Thank you. If you're just joining us, thank you. If you've been with us, I love you all equally. Okay? Alright. Please, I want to use this medium to announce to everyone that we are going to be coming to the end of consultation finally on the 28th of December, okay? It is supposed to stop tomorrow being 25th, but the queue is much. So, we are going to be extending it until the 28th of December, okay? To resume finally in January, okay? So, please, if your money is coming in after 28th, please, I'm so sorry. I won't accept it because by then it must have been late, okay? Of course, we need to rest. We need to also enjoy, you know, you are enjoying in your various homes. So we need space too. Yes. Okay, that being said, today we are going to be talking about reincarnate and your guardian spirit, okay? I've gotten a lot of messages in this regard. Many people are asking me to talk about this topic. And then today I've decided to talk about it. Okay, I wanted to talk about it by next year. But it looks like a lot of people are into one problem or the other. The confusion is too much. So I want to also clear the confusion in their heads so that by the end of this year, they know that already they know where their problem is coming from, or maybe they have an idea, a little iota of idea of what the problem is. And then maybe they will decide to look for the solution this year or by next year. You understand? But at least one thing is to know where your problem is coming from, and another thing is to get ready for it to be solved. Okay, so that is why I've decided to talk about it today. All right, let's not waste time. I'm going to be starting with guidance spirit. Okay, some people call it guidance angel. It's still the same thing because, of course, an angel angel is a spirit. Okay, yes, and spirit is an angel. An angel is a spirit. A human being cannot be an angel. Okay. It has to be a spirit, okay? It depends on what you understand and how you decide to call it, okay? I choose to call it a guidance spirit because this, your guidance spirit, is your chi. This is the spirit that comes with you on the day you were born. On your day of delivery, it rejoices with you that you have come to live in this earth. Okay, your guidance spirit has a very important role to play in your life. If your guidance spirit is in chains, you will not be able to move forward. Yes, that's true. If your guidance angel is caged spiritually, if it is caged, you cannot move further than your guidance spirit. That is the truth. Because many guidance spirits are caged. They are in chains that they cannot allow you to move forward. Because your guidance spirit loves you more than any other thing. Your guidance spirit loves and cares for you. They don't hate you, they love you a lot. But the problem is that most of us do not recognize them. Do you remember that you found yourself in several situations where you were about to do something? You hear a voice within you telling you to do this, do that, go ahead and do it. Oh, please don't do this. Don't, if you do this, you're going to regret it. You will still not listen because you're not in good times with that, your guidance spirit. You will still not listen. You will go ahead and do it. And at the end of the day, you will keep regretting. Oh my God, why did I listen to my instinct? English people call it instinct. And see, that is your guidance spirit. You should discover who your guidance spirit is. Your guidance spirit, you cannot actually know if it's a man or a woman. You cannot know. It is only what he or she does that will make you to call it a great guidance spirit. Yes. If it behaves like a man, you know, the voice and other things it does behaves like a man, you can call it a guide, a male guardian spirit. But if it behaves like a woman, that is when you can say, oh, this my guardian spirit is so caring and, you know, behaves like a mother, like a woman. Okay? Need I tell you that your guidance spirit is just like a shadow? It goes with you to wherever you go to. It's whatever that bothers you bothers your guidance spirit. It wants you to be successful. It wants you to succeed. You know, your guidance spirit wants you to be to excel in all your dealings. But the problem is that you do not recognize it. You don't even know that you have come to this world with a guidance spirit. That is why whenever it's talking to you, whenever it's trying to communicate to you, to tell you there are something, your guidance spirit can actually appear to you in dreams, to warn you over things, to tell you that you shouldn't trade on this path, to tell you that you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that, please go ahead and do this. That business you want, you're planning to venture in, it's going to swallow your money. Don't do this. Don't even try it, you know. It's going to be warning you. But because you don't even know, you feel like it's just a voice that is talking to you. What if it's a fake voice? What if it's an original voice? Some people don't even know. They can't even differentiate between when an angel is talking to them and then when another voice is talking to them. So today, that is why I've decided to tell you to clear the confusion in the air. There is actually guidance spirit, okay? But the truth is that if it's in chains, you will be in chains. If it's in chains spiritually, then you are not going to be moving forward spiritually. Because my people said that onye bulu chiuzo or babu onwe anaso. If you run faster than your guidance spirit, you will run to your own grave. That is just the truth. If your guidance spirit is not, isn't changed, you cannot be successful. This is where you see that somebody is striving so hard to do what he is supposed to do as a human being to succeed, but he sees himself always running around, and at the end of the day, you have nothing to show for it. Because Nandibaina sin abaka mumbobe goni. Because there are people that stay at home and make millions of money. And there are people that toil and push wheelbarrow, and at the end of the day, they can't even feed themselves properly. Do you understand? Are you telling me that God does not like them? It's about guidance spirit. It's about the guidance spirit, the spirit you have come to this world with, to monitor you, to monitor your dealings, to guide you. It is just a guidance spirit. It's a guidance. It's going to guide you on what to do. Do you understand? On what to do, on the path to trade and be successful in your dealings. Okay? So today, if after this video, I tell you, you should discover who your guidance spirit is. Okay, so that you will acknowledge your guidance spirit, because it will do you good. Your guidance spirit has a lot of role to play in your life. If it is changed, then you need to unchain it for you to succeed, for you to move forward. Okay, all right, that being said, the next one we are going to be talking about today is your reincarnate. Many people have, honestly, I've gotten a lot of messages in this regard, and I said, I'm going to treat it together, okay? Because these are the things that makes you who you are. These are the things that when you know your reincarnate, when you know your guidance spirit, you will appreciate nature. You will appreciate God, because all the things you are doing will be working for you, and it will look like you have done charm, you have done rituals. Let me tell you, do you know that there are people that their guidance spirit, there are people that have naturally they have great guidance spirits, and they also have great reincarnates. And if you're in good terms with them, then you don't have any fears to entertain, because your life will be so beautiful. Yes, that's true. Okay, I am going to be quickly touching the part I said I'm going to touch, which is about the reincarnate. Yes, stay tuned. Okay, I'm finally here. Well, your reincarnate is the person you were in your past life. Do I need to tell you that everybody, we all reincarnated, and some people are yet to reincarnate, okay? The person you were in your past life. And how do you know this? If your parents are still alive, go and inquire from them. Who is your reincarnate? That is, who were you? Who reincarnated you? Like, who you were. That will help you to determine, to know who you were in your past life. If you were a very tough person in your past life, or if you are, you know, very, you know, calm. And then if you were rich, or if you were poor. What brings about reincarnation? In the spirit world, you know, people come to this world on a mission, okay? They come to this world on a mission, and send them on a mission to come and accomplish their mission. Then, but if the person is not able to accomplish his or her mission, the person dies, okay? Then if the person goes to the spirit world, they give the person a second chance to come around. So the second chance they are giving, some people came as a result, some people are coming to their third life. Yes. That is why you see some people, you see, you know, reincarnation, they seem to have the same talent. That's why you see in some families, they are wrestlers. They are good in wrestling. From generation to generation, they know them as wrestlers. You see some people, they are very good in making hair. Whatever it is that is hair, they know them with it. You know, what some people, you see them that there are so many talents. They are usually, you know, they are usually talented. Reincarnation, people that have reincarnated, they have different common, you know, talents. They have common talents. Just like people that dance very well, that do this, you know, native dance, you know, all this local dance. You see them that they dance very well, more than every other person in that community. And whenever they want to tell you to go and, you know, to go and call people that will dance for you, it must be from that family. Some people, they come from the lineage of kings. You understand, there are so many other things, but I just have to mention little or few of it so that you will have an idea of what I'm talking about. So your reincarnate is who you were in your past life. And so people, the truth is that the person that reincarnated, you cannot be alive while you are alive. The person has to come, stay and die. But your parents will tell you who the person was, if they are the people that do consultation when you were still small. In some families, they do this. Immediately they give birth to you, they go and consult for you to know who reincarnated you, okay? Who your reincarnate is, because this will help you. It's an easy access to life. It's going to help you to know who you are. It's going to help you to know where you belong. It's going to help you to know where you come from. That brings me to one question. Many people have been asking me, my realm of origin is earth, or my realm of origin is water, is air. How come that my reincarnate is, how come I'm having issues? I have different issues with the marine world. I always see myself in the dream swimming. I always have encounter with the marine people, you know. Well, your reincarnate has a great role to play in this. But the truth is that the proper thing is that your reincarnate is supposed to come from the same realm of origin with you. But in some cases, it's not like that. So the only thing that would determine this is consultation. I am not the one that would tell you if it's like that in your life or it's not like that. The only way you can find out is by for you to consult a spiritualist who will help you to find out where you came from, who reincarnated you. If if the person that reincarnated you is from the marine world and is disturbing you, because the truth is that your reincarnate can be the source of your joy or the source of your tears. It could be the reason you have been passing through a lot of things, have been going through one problem or the other. It wants you to actually acknowledge it. It wants you to know who he is or who she is. Have you ever seen a case where someone is brought in for rituals, to be used for money rituals or any kind of ritual, and then the person is rejected? It is your guidance spirit that causes it. You are in good terms with your guidance spirit, and your guidance spirit doesn't want anything evil to happen to you. Just like you've been in a bus, and there was an accident, a fatal accident, and then you were saved while others died. Chiabuyotu. My people used to say that Chiabuyotu. We do not have the same guardian spirits. okay? We do not have the same guidance spirit. There are guidance spirits that are tougher than the other. There are guidance spirits that are that will stick to you wherever you go to. You see yourself always escaping from gunshots, death, and other stuff. And you think it's a coincidence, or maybe it's like that. No. It's something is causing it. Your guidance spirit is ticked to you. It doesn't want you to get hurt. It doesn't want you to, you know. And it's actually God, because God is the maker of the whole universe. He's the creator of heaven and earth. He is the one that assigned all these guidance spirits to come to the world with us. He assigned them to us. That is called your guidance angel. Mobulundi Suloibo. They said it's guidance angel. Let me say guidance angel so that you don't get confused or you don't misunderstand me, okay? Because guidance, like I said before, angels are spirits. Spirits are angels. So what are we talking about? I decide to call it guidance spirit. But now let me call it guidance angel so that it will sound sweet. An angel, yes. So this is it. It's your guidance angel that is always, you know, that is always in the position to help you, protecting you, and always, you know, there for you. But when you don't recognize it, or maybe when it's in chains, this is where your life becomes miserable, because it's not even its fault. It cannot help you, okay? It cannot be of help to you. It could be from witches. It could be from people there are some forces that can cause a guidance angel, to, you know, be in chains, okay? To be in chains, like caged. It cannot move. It cannot do anything. And it's going to stampede your life and make your life to be stagnated. Okay, so today that you've known the truth will set you free, because we are here to see, to learn. We are here to learn, and then we are here to gain knowledge. And then knowledge is power. When you are informed, you'll be transformed. When you are not informed, you will be deformed, because you will not even know where you will be starting from and where you will be, you know, ending to. So today you have known it. So please look for your guidance spirits. You can connect with them with your candles. I'm going to teach that in another video, okay? You can connect with them with candles, you know. Can connect, you know, their world. They need candles. They need candles for them to see light, okay? For them to have a connection with you. Can communicate with them with light. Candle lights, different colors, depends on your realm of origin, okay? So that you can communicate with them. You tell them what your problem is. Cry unto them. They are your guidance spirits. And then your reincarnator, that is another problem. If your reincarnate is angry with you, then sorry, your life will be somehow. So do something today to save yourself and save your situation. All right? Okay. Consultation will also tell you who your reincarnate is. Okay? Yeah, but if your parents are alive, please tell them. They will tell you, you know, they will let you know. That is even better, okay? They will tell you so that you don't have to spend money. Yeah. So, all right. I'm going to be coming to the end of today's video. If you enjoyed this video, please give me thumbs up. Because this thumbs up you're giving to me, it makes me, you know that what I'm doing is you like it, so that I will continue doing it. Because if I don't see encouragement, I'll be discouraged to teach what I'm teaching, all right? So, okay, that is it. And then we are going to be coming to the end of today's video. If you're just joining us, you're welcome. If you've been with us, I really appreciate you, okay? So, please put on your notification button on to get our notifications. And also, please try and subscribe. And thank you, guys. We are increasing, and I'm happy about it. Thank you very much, and do have a lovely day. Bye. I care. You know I care. Bye.